Oh, come on. You just told me what to do. I'm just repeating what you said.
No, that's true.
To the first episode.
First episode.
Of the Whiskey Cocktail Club. She drives me to drinking.
So when's the last time you had a Jack Daniels?
3-4 years ago, I think.
What do you think now?
After my whiskey journey, it's not as bad as I remember. There's still a couple of things in the flavor that I don't like. But it's. I think the difference is that I'm used to spirits now. And as a result, it's not kicking my ass.
Today, since you have your Jack Daniels here, we're actually going to explore Jack Daniels and Coke, which is one of the...
Of course a cat. I'm sorry. The Velcro didn't hold.
So the reason that we're doing Jack and Coke today is it's actually one of the number one drinks in the United States and pretty much the world. Jack Daniels is accessible, cheap, and everybody knows it. And it's easy.
Mm-hmm.
So what I've done is we're going to explore Jack Daniels and Coke. Coke Lite, which for those of you who are not here in Europe, is the Dutch version of Diet Coke. And then we have Jack Daniels' own Jack and Cola. So we'll go ahead and start with the regular Coke. We put about 40 milliliters of Jack in here and filled the Coke up to the top with ice. And to me, the taste of the cola is almost overwhelming.
It is overwhelming.
I do taste a little bit of the typical Jack flavor coming through.
There's some sweetness, extra sweetness in there. It's almost like it's extra sweet.
Yeah.
With a little bit of a hint of vanilla. And I would say a little hint of, you know, the banana candy?
Mm.
Slight hint of banana candy in there.
Still probably not one of my favorite drinks.
No.
Personally, if I'm going to do a whiskey and Coke, I generally do it with a Diet Coke. It's a little less sweet. The flavor of the whiskey comes out.
Well, good thing we have one.
And did you know Diet Coke actually gets you drunk faster? The Jack is definitely coming out more. I taste a little bit of the vanilla coming through now, which really pairs with the sweetener that they used in the Coke Lite.
For me, most obvious is it's a lot less sweet. The sweetness that you have on a normal Coke is almost like this like you're drinking syrup. And this is, it's more like you're drinking Coke. I taste the same notes in it that I notice in the normal Coke and Jack Daniels, but I get a little hint of the barrel tang in the Diet Coke that I don't get in the normal Coke that is in the Jack Daniels when you drink it straight.
And a little bit of the barrel char that I can always detect.
Yeah, what you guys don't know, she says that we're doing this to test whiskey cocktails. I'm doing this in the hope that she gets into whiskey. And for that, I need a gateway. Cocktails are the perfect gateway. Apparently, she can still taste the barrel char. This is my disappointed face. So now, the third one we have is the one that Jack Daniels sells on the shelf. Jack and Cola.
Have you ever tried this?
Never tried it.
Neither have I, so this is going to be an adventure.
Take a shot. Now, for those of you that wonder, we're sharing glasses. We're married. We have proof that we're married. Anyways, so it's safe.
It's interesting. It doesn't have the syrupy mouthfeel that the regular Coke has. And it doesn't have the bitter, almost tangy aftertaste that the Coke Lite has. It's actually pretty smooth. But I don't feel that there is a lot of alcohol content in this. The Jack isn't coming through, and I don't have my glasses on, so you need to read and see how much Jack is in there.
They don't... Oh, 6% ABV is in the total mix. That is considerably less than what we put in these glasses. Because I think the glasses are 200 milliliters. We put a huge amount of ice in there. And 40 milliliters of Jack. So it's probably close to 15 or 20% that we made by hand. And this... I can't even taste the Jack.